Hi everybody, I hope you all are fine, safe and secure at home. Our college staff members have tried these types of videos for helping you to recalling our subjects. Okay, let us move to the subject. Just I am going to give a short introduction about object-oriented programming with C++. First, we have the definition of OOPs. Object-oriented programming is a new approach that creates partition memory area for both data and functions. It also acts as templates for creating copies of modules on demand. The memory stores data and also performs set of operations that can access that data. By seeing this diagram, we will be very clear about the definition and feature of OOPs. In OOPs, all the things are represented as objects. Here, there are three objects named Object A, Object B and Object C. Each object contains data and function. Objects share the partition memory area for both data and functions. Also, the object ties the data and function together. This method is called information hiding or data hiding. One object will communicate with other object through functions. It is represented as message passing or message communication. We can upgrade easily the data and functions. Now we are going to see the striking feature of OOPs. It emphasizes on data, not procedure. Programs are divided into objects. Functions and data are tied together to the object. Data is hidden and cannot be accessed by external functions. Objects may communicate with each other through functions. New data and functions can be easily added whenever necessary. Now we move on to the basic concepts of OOPs. It is very important feature in OOPs. There are 8 basic concepts of OOPs. The first one is objects, class, data abstraction, data encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, dynamic binding and message passing. Encapsulation, inheritance and polymorphism are 3 pillars of object-oriented development. The first basic concept of OOP is object. Objects are nothing but runtime entities. They may represent a person, a place, a bank account, a table of data, or any item that the program must handle. Program objects match closely with the real-world objects. Objects take space in the memory. When a program is executed, the objects interact by sending message to another object. This picture denotes the way to represent an object. The representation of object contains 3 parts. The first part contains object name. Second part contains the information about the object, that is called data. The third part contains operation of an object, that is called functions. Here we have taken the example object name as student, then the data for the student is student name and student marks. The functions of student is we have to calculate the total marks of the student and display the student mark. This is one of the example for object. The second basic concepts of OOPs is classes. The entire set of a data and code of an object can be made a user-defined data type with the help of a class. Objects are variable of type class. Once a class has been defined, we can create any number of objects belonging to that class. A class is thus a collection of objects of similar type. Classes are user-defined data types and behave like the built-in types of a programming language. The third concept is data abstraction. Abstraction refers to the act of representing essential features without including the background details. Classes use the concept of abstraction to list out abstract attributes such as size, weight, and cost. Since the classes uses the concept of data abstraction, they are known as abstract data type. The fourth concept is encapsulation. The wrapping up of a data and function into a single unit is known as encapsulation. The data is not accessible to the outside world. This insulation of data is called data hiding or information hiding. The best example for encapsulation in the real world is capsule, that we are using in our day-to-day life. Because all elements or particles are kept inside the capsule very safe. So it is named as capsule. The fourth concept is inheritance. Inheritance is the process of receiving some characteristics or properties from one class to another class. There are two classes. The first class is said to be a base class and the second class is said to be a derived class. Both the classes having a common characteristics. In OOPS, the concept of inheritance provides the idea of reusability. This means that we can add additional features to an existing class without modifying it. Let us consider the real-time example for inheritance. Consider us. We are having some characteristics of our grandmother and some characteristics of mother and some special characteristics for us. So we are getting some characteristics from our grandmother and mother and some special characteristics for us. This is the best real-time example for inheritance. The sixth concept of OOPS is polymorphism. Polymorphism means the ability to take more than one form. That is, an operation may exhibit different behavior in different instances. Take the operation of addition. If you are adding two integers, the result will be integer. If you are adding two strings, the result will be concatenation of string. It is called different behavior in different instances. According to this, the polymorphism is divided into two parts, named operator overloading and function overloading. The second basic concepts of OOPS is classes. The entire set of a data and code of an object can be made a user-defined data type with the help of a class. Objects are variable. The third concept is data abstraction. Abstraction refers to the act of representing essential features without including the background details. Classes use the concept of abstraction. The last concept of OOPS is message communication. The object is communicate with one another through sending and receiving the information as the same way people pass message to one another. There are three steps to be followed while the object is communicating. The first step is we have to specify the object name. Second step, we have to specify the function. Third step, the information to be sent. Now I have to take the example as employee as the object. In the first step, I have mentioned the employee name as an object name. In the second step, I have calculated the salary as the function. In the third step, I have sent the information of the employee name and his salary to another object. Thank you, students.